Good day, my name is Bob van der Hulst and I'm the Art Strategist of APM Terminals Maasvlakte 2. In this video I will start with a general introduction of our terminal. Then we will look deeper into the yard and its applied stacking logic. Concluding, I will explain how we calculate our yard density forecasting and its determining factors. So, let's start with some general data of our terminal. Maasvlakte 2 opened in 2015 and remains the world's most advanced fully automated terminal. Around 80% of the crane movements are automated, with the remaining manual operations being done remotely. There are 10 Super K cranes, SQCs, 3 K cranes, 2 rail cranes and 54 automated rail gantry cranes on the terminal site. All these cranes are served by 74 lift automated guided vehicles. This equipment, together with 450 employees, made it possible in 2020 to have a record-breaking year with almost 1.1 million SQC moves executed. The containers related to these moves all float through the yard. There are 3 dedicated barge stacks, 6 rail stacks and 18 truck stacks. Within these stacks, there are dedicated areas for reefers, IMOs and 45 foots. Within the stack, we want to stack as many containers as possible, while doing it as efficiently as possible, which means minimizing moving a container. To decide which is the best position for the container, we have to choose the right logic. There are many different factors which influence this decision. For example, what's inside the container? Does it need special treatment, like a reefer or an IMO? When is the container leaving the terminal again? What are the yard conditions at the moment of assigning a position? And which other containers are already standing in the yard? Based on all these factors, a decision is made where to stack the container. The process flow is as follows. A container arrives at the terminal. Based on its characteristics, it is put into an allocation group. Such an allocation group has multiple allocation ranges within the yard. These are all positions where the containers of that allocation group can be stacked. Each allocation range then has a specific expert decking strategy applied. Such a strategy consists of over 80 different penalties. Expert decking then calculates a score for every single position within the yard and chooses the position with the lowest score. The container is then stacked within the yard. The operational capacity is the starting point for calculating our safe operating capacity. This is the amount of SQC moves the terminal and thus the yard can handle on a weekly basis. Besides the operational yard storage capacity, the limiting factor for the safe operating capacity is dwell time, and as a result, yard density. With every decrease of the dwell time, the safe operating capacity increases exponentially. Thus, having a lower dwell time means being able to cope with bigger volumes flowing through the terminal. If the dwell time and or volume is too high, it will end up with a pileup of containers in the yard, which is higher density. This will have an immediate negative impact on the productivity of the deep sea quay, barge quay, rail track and truck quay, meaning longer port stays and higher truck turnaround time. Besides calculating the current yard density, we of course want to forecast the yard density in the near future. This to identify potential bottlenecks and to take proactive measures to resolve these bottlenecks. The starting point of such a yard density forecast is always the current yard density. From there, we forecast how the yard density will evolve based on the berthing lineup. We do this by predicting when containers will arrive or depart. This is done for every single vessel visit in the berthing lineup, for which we create patterns. For a load call, we create a receival pattern, meaning we predict when containers will arrive at the terminal. For a discharge call, we create a delivery pattern, meaning we try to predict when containers will depart from the terminal. For a mixed call, doing both load and discharge moves, we create a receival and delivery pattern, trying to predict when containers will arrive and containers will depart. The starting point for all these patterns are the amount of moves being received from the line operators. These moves are then spread over time based on historical data on a service level. There are separate patterns created for the whole berthing lineup. When all these patterns are summed up, it will result in a total yard density forecast. These patterns will get updated every 4 hours with the actual status of the yard, thus the amount of containers already being in the yard for a specific vessel visit. These patterns then get adjusted, if required, and the yard density forecast becomes as realistic as possible. However, it remains a forecast, and it's only as good as the information we put into it. Therefore, it is super important to have the most accurate information as possible. This is both applicable on a container level and on a service level. On a container level, the booking data is most important, and then specifically the outbound modality, or even better, the outbound vessel, train or barge. On a service level, it all starts with the ETA, total amount of discharge, load and restow moves. The yard density forecast can even become more accurate if these moves can be specified between IMOs, reefers, OOGs and empties. It can be further improved if deviating flows are known upfront, such as transshipment flows and empty evacuation planning. Concluding, the more accurate information, the better the yard density forecast in the end will be. Thank you for watching this video about our yard.